George Creel and the 4-Minute American. George Creel was an American journalist who would later become police chief in Denver, Colorado, but was best known for his participation in the Public Information Committee for President Wilson prior to our entry into World War I. Wilson had the difficult task of convincing Americans that our physical entry into that theater in Europe was important to our survival, and it was a tough sell, and Creel was the man to do that. Now, there were other people involved besides Creel. There was Carl Bjor. Edward Bernays was the nephew of Sigmund Freud. He was involved in public relations. But Creel was the real ace in the deck. And Creel's belief was that Americans had a short attention span, they were uneducated, and it was probably best to use quick propaganda to influence them. So therefore, he sent 70 to 80,000, quote-unquote, 4-minute men to go around the country to give 4-minute speeches promoting our entry into the war. It was really, really effective, and even some of the progressive, the left side of the political spectrum in the United States were swayed. Educator John Dewey, who was a progressive, sided with the president. There's probably only one or two real well-known people who went against Wilson. One would be one of my heroes, Randolph Bourne, who was a hunchback midget who had a lot of health problems, but he was a brilliant man. Unfortunately, he died in 1918. He didn't buy Creel's methods, and he didn't buy what Wilson was promoting. Be that as it may, I think that it has a lot of relevance to today. And what I mean by that is that if you look at songs, they're all usually, at least the successful ones, are under 4 minutes today. You don't see the 11-minute progressive songs you would hear in the 1970s. Not at all. It just doesn't happen anymore. YouTube videos, those videos which are most viewed are usually the ones in shorter time. And as I look at our society today, I think that the small doses are probably the most effective way to market ideas to people. And that doesn't mean it's a good thing. It just means that it happens. And I should add that Creel was later a part of Joseph McCarthy's anti-communism campaign. Nixon was involved with that. And again, Creel was very, very effective at what he did. And I think that what you see today, which is more or less a marketing method of promoting whatever, Creel played a large role in that. And probably intuitively, he may not have had the intellect that Bernays had or Bjor, but he had his deck working. And perhaps, unfortunately.